In nature, subsurface rocks are water wet. Their pores are initially saturated with formation brine. The question which may come up in your mind is how the oil has existed nowadays in these pores which were initially filled with water. For oil to be able to displace water inside the pores and take its place, there must be a force which allows this process to happen. This force is generated from the capillary pressure, which will be our topic in this video. Whenever two immiscible liquids coexist in a system, capillary pressure forces are created at their interface. These forces push oil inside the pores to an extent which is dependent on the force's value. When oil starts to displace water, it displaces the layers which exist at the metal because of the fact that oil is the non-wetting phase. Oil starts replacing centered water layers in wide pores before narrow ones. Capillary pressure curve is a very useful and simple mean for understanding the oil-water displacement process inside rock pores. Capillary pressure curve is a relation between capillary pressure and fluid saturation inside the pores. At zero capillary pressure, water saturation in pores is 100% as oil doesn't own any driving force to be able to displace water from inside the pores. As capillary pressure increases up to a certain limit, water saturation remains the same. Although oil now has a driving force to push it inside pores, it's not sufficient to overcome the existing water-oil interfacial tension and displace water. Up to a certain capillary pressure value, oil's driving force becomes exactly equal to the interfacial tension. Any pressure slightly higher than this pressure will successfully force oil inside rock pores. This critical capillary pressure is called entry pressure or displacement pressure. After reaching this value, oil saturation increases with increasing capillary pressure and water saturation decreases. Each capillary pressure value will be corresponding to a specific oil-water saturation value. This relation will continue to happen until all water at the center is displaced and the only water left is the layer adhered to the rock grains due to wettability effects. At this point, no more water can be expelled, and water saturation is called irreducible or connate water saturation. Rock grains can't possess higher oil saturation than that reached, no matter how capillary pressure value is increasing. Capillary pressure curve can be transformed into a height saturation relation by converting capillary pressure scale into height scale. Since P capillary equal rho g h, h equal B capillary over rho g. By this conversion, we can relate various depths with oil-water saturation. The height at which capillary pressure is equal to zero is called free water level. Water saturation is equal to 100%. The height at which displacement capillary pressure exists is called oil-water contact. This level separates water region from oil-water mixed region. Water saturation is also 100%. The range of height at which saturation changes with capillary pressure changes is called transition zone. It is the zone where both oil and water are simultaneously produced if drilled. The height that exists after reaching the irreducible water saturation is called the oil zone. It is the zone of the formation which is actually drilled. That's because water can be produced in this zone due to the adhesion forces with the rock grains. It is important to understand capillary pressure and its effect on oil-water saturation. It demonstrates the nature of oil existence inside rock pores. It also gives a way to understand the locations of oil zone, transition zone, and water zone underground. If you liked this video, please support us by hitting the like and subscribe buttons below. Don't forget to share it with your friends for their benefit. Thanks for watching.